Click it, and then we'll do Allentown. Pennsylvania, perfect. Get leads. Hey guys, what's up? Today we're gonna be checking out D7 Lead Finder. We're gonna build a list of plumbers in Allentown, Pennsylvania, and we're gonna compare it to Coldlytics. But first we're gonna take a complete look at D7 Lead Finder, all its features. So let's go for plumbers. So I'll pause this while it runs its search. All right, so we got our results back. And as you can see, you know, we've got social media links in here. We can find their position on Google for that particular search for plumbers in Allentown. There's some neat features here, and then emails, of course. The problem that I find with D7 is that a lot of them are generic inboxes. So info ats and AP, whatever that is. Accounts payable, I assume, is the email that they just gave us. Some of these are direct. You can see Eric at, inquiries at. But the other problem is that we don't know who that is. We don't know who Eric is at Romy HVAC. So we don't know if we're emailing an owner, if we're emailing somebody on the executive suite, if it's, you know, the front desk clerk. We have no idea who we're getting for contacts here. So you're left with a bunch of potential leads, but we don't have any idea who they actually are, which makes it pretty difficult to use this data. So there's, but none of them are telling us if it's the owner. You can play around with some of these settings inside of filters. I've turned them all on, so you can see here exactly what the different data points are that are available. But otherwise, you'll have to go in and manually turn these on yourself as well. I hide leads without an email address, so that list would be bigger if we didn't need an email address, but I like to have an email address for every contact, so I turned this on for this comparison. It's okay if they didn't have a phone number, I left that off. And they have to have a website URL as well. I left that on. So you guys can play around with these. D7 Lead Finder is good for finding a bulk list of leads, but you really need to scrub that down, filter it. You have to research each individual lead and figure out who that contact is at those companies. And then you have to do your outreach from there. So it still leaves a ton of work for you to do. That's going to conclude the D7 Lead Finder review. When we ran our comparison data set between D7 Lead Finder and Coldlytics, here's what we found. We found 68 leads back from D7 Lead Finder, 9 of which were an actual match. So if you were to spend 2 minutes per lead to try and verify if you had the owner's contact, if it was a valid lead at all, and you were paying yourself or somebody on your team $23 an hour, which is the median wage for account executives in the United States, then you would have spent $52 on this list and paid basically $6 per lead that you got back. So it turns out to be very expensive if you have any value in your time. If we jump over to Coldlytics, you'll see here that we found a total of 21 leads, most of which have valid emails. The yellow ones came back as catch-all. We have a no bounce guarantee. So if these bounce, you can just send us a message and we'll put those credits back in your account. But we leave them there to maximize the amount of opportunities that you find from our lead list. You can see we have social profile links, we have phone numbers, mailing addresses, and then we even have a bunch of other data points that you can get from inside Coldlytics. So let's take a look, if you were to go build this list right now inside of Coldlytics, how that would work. We'll start out by going to coldlytics.com. We're gonna click on sign up in the top right corner, but in this case, I'm gonna click on log in for my own account. And we'll click on new task right here, the big blue button. And we'll start by setting how many leads we're looking for. So let's say we're looking for up to 100 leads or up to 1,000 leads. Then how many contacts per company are you looking for? 1, 2, 3. I'm just going to keep this at 1. General targeting. This is where we start to get into the seniority level. So unlike D7 Lead Finder, we couldn't set the owners and founders, but that's the first thing we're going to do here is select that, and directors and executives as well. Then we can actually keep scrolling down. I mean, we could just put plumbing and then do United States like this. But if we want to get a little bit more specific and we want to do the Allentown, Pennsylvania search, we're going to use Google Maps. So to pull up Google Maps, we clicked on that blue text and we're going to search for plumbers in Allentown, Pennsylvania. So let's make sure we have the correct result here on our screen. Perfect. We're going to copy this URL and we're going to bring it over to Coldlytics. And how Coldlytics works is that on the back end, we're scraping all of these companies that you see here in Google Business Profiles, but we're checking their websites to make sure that they're a match. that they are in fact plumbing businesses. And then what we do is we have a team of human researchers who are experts in finding the email addresses for the owners of these businesses along with phone numbers for them. So we're effectively building a fairly exhaustive list, because if they're not on Google Business, if they don't have a Google Business profile, they're not on Google Maps, then chances are they're not big enough for whatever you need to outreach to anyway. And they may not be around very long at all if they're not on Google, right? So this is a pretty exhaustive list of plumbing companies in Allentown, Pennsylvania. We brought that over to Coldlytics, as we showed you here, pasted it in. And then at the bottom in the additional notes, you can clarify if you want what you're looking for. So you could say something like looking for plumbers in Allentown, PA. And then we'd come to the next screen, and this is where we're gonna get into the data points. So by default, every list has the first and last name of the person, their job title, and the company that they're at, their email address, and the link to the company website. But we can also provide a lot more information. We can get their LinkedIn profile link if they have one. We can find the complete address for that person, for that company, and it's split into the city, state, zip. We can get the phone number for the business, of course, or the direct dial for that individual. That would be like a mobile number or a desk number if they have a desk. We can get the Google review count and score. We can get you the link to their Google Business profile, and we can also tell you if they've claimed their Google Business profile. We can get their social media profile links for the company. We can detect if they have an advertising pixel installed, so you can figure out if they're doing any retargeting and if they're running ads. We can tell you if they have Google Analytics installed on their website, as well as if they have an e-commerce function on their website. So that would mean there's a checkout somewhere on their website. We can tell you if they've built their website on WordPress. And we can also tell you how fast the website loaded in milliseconds. And this is a great data point if you're selling SEO services, because of course you can sell to Google's 2-second rule and how it will help them increase their rankings based on page speed, and it's one of the key indicators in ranking. So this is a great thing to be able to compare to. You can also compare to their competitors and say, we looked and on average, websites in your city are loading in 4 seconds. We can get you better than that. We can get you into Google's, you know, ideal 2 seconds or less zone, and you'll probably make it into the 3-pack. So that's interesting. That's an interesting way to use this data point. It's my favorite one. You would just click them like this to add them to your list. We'll click on the blue next button. We'll give this task a name. We'll call it Plumbers in Allentown, PA, and we'll hit Start Task. And then what happens is we generate a Google Sheet and we start to scrape down all the company information. And then within 24 hours, our research team will have gone out and researched as many emails and phone numbers as we possibly can for you based on your request. And we'll notify you by email as soon as it's ready with a link to the Google Sheet. So you can come and access your data, download it, take it anywhere you need to go, or you can use one of our integrations like Lemlist to push it into an email campaign and start using it right away. If you guys have any questions, we do have a chat bubble here in the bottom right corner. It goes directly to myself. I'm one of the co-founders of the company, and my co-founder, Richard Francis, here. So we're happy to answer any questions anytime. Appreciate you guys watching this video, and have a great day.